A Trip Almost Cut Short by Stephen Remy. It was mid-June, summer of 2016, and my brother came rushing into my room asking if I wanted to go camping with him and some buddies up at Rainbow Creek Falls later tonight. Just like any other responsible sophomore in college, I briefly think of if I have any work or anything scheduled to do, and I don't, luckily, so I say sure and quickly get up and start getting ready. First things first, I head downstairs and make myself a delicious breakfast. My all-time favorite and specialty to make is a bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich, usually paired with a fruit cup and a cup of orange juice to fuel me for the rest of the day. After I finish showering and getting ready, I grab my camping pack and began to pack. Looping continuously throughout my house, one by one, I grab the gear and items I was bringing with me. My Eno hammock to sleep in so I can be off the ground away from the bugs. A sleeping bag for warmth and a sleeping pad for support, and a headlamp to see and much more, as well as a fire starter kit, food, and water bottle for obvious reasons. Once I finished going through the list and grabbing everything I needed, I looked through the line of gear on the ground to double check I had everything, because in the past when I have forgotten things, it has made the whole trip so much more difficult, so now I'm extra precautious to make sure it doesn't happen again. With the double check complete, I packed it all up in my pack and hopped in the car with my brother and Kendall, and we hit the road. No better way to start a trip than cramming into a car, right? The trailhead was 3.5 hours away from home, and after about an hour and a half of driving, we stopped at a QT or Quick Trip to grab gas and grab something to drink and some snacks. A little while after, we stopped once more at an Ingles grocery store to grab beer, fried chicken for dinner in the car on the rest of the way up, and some more supplies. Everything else to survive, we were told, was already up the campsite waiting for us. Hitting the road again, the sun began to set and the sky slowly darkened to a near pitch black, making it nearly impossible to see road signs and making correct turns. My hopes of reaching the trailhead in time slowly started to fade after we had been driving around in loops for about an hour. Cell service was limited, and the little bits we did get weren't enough to load maps or directions. We began to go into local gas stations asking if anyone could point us in the direction of Rainbow Creek Falls. Luckily, at the third stop, a man responded with the best news of the trip. "Turn right out of here and go down the road until there is a silo on the left and take the first right after it. Go another half mile or so after it, and you should see the brown Rainbow Creek Trail sign right up ahead on the right." After talking to the man at the gas station, we quickly hopped back in the car and headed in the direction he told us. We were able to call my brother, who had been waiting at the trailhead for a while now, to tell him we were only 5 minutes away. We pulled up to the trailhead, and sure enough, he and his girlfriend were sitting there with only their headlamps visible in the dark. After a brief chat, we grabbed our bags and followed them down the trail for a mile and a half until we stumbled upon the campsite and met up with the others. At camp, most of it was already set up, and there was a fire roaring in the middle. Camp was next to a river for water supplies so we could make food and put out the fire, and camp was just off the trail for easy access. It's about 11 p.m. now, and the stars and moons are shining bright up above, and the nighttime noises are providing tunes for the evening. After we finished setting up our hammocks and sleeping quarters, the fun began when we broke out the beer and started making s'mores and sitting around the fire having a great time. We planned the next day's hike to the falls and slowly lost people who went off to bed. I was the last one up as usual, so I put out the fire and headed to bed myself. The next morning came and the trip continued as followed in the videos.